Hi everyone. So in the coming videos, we will be talking more about classes, interface, abstract classes, and how to create a public private variables and functions in a classes. Okay. So let's talk about the first class, which is variable. Here we will talk about how we can declare a variable using public. So here I'm declaring a as a public variable, having value, default value also there. You can also create the private variable. B is of type number and 90 is the value. Okay. Similarly, you can also use the protected word to define the number, and default value is null, or it can be of type string and value I'm assigning initially is of type null. Okay. Similarly, you can also create a variable without type. So in this case, those will be a public by default, or like I'm creating E is of type any, like this, and it can be, you can declare that as a public. Okay, so this is how we are actually declaring the variables inside a class. And how to create an instance of this? We just create an object of a class. It's the same as we are doing in every other programming language. Here we are creating the object of the class. Now let's introduce the constructor inside a class. Class, my class. And what we are having the variables inside it, like private. P1 is of type number. And here we have a private. Similarly, like let me create a three variables quickly, p1, p2, and p3, and of a different type. It can be of type string, it can be a type of boolean. Okay, here I'm creating constructor. So constructor is the function which gets invoked whenever you are creating the object with a new keyword. So param1 of type number, there is a param2 of type boolean, and param3 of type string. Okay, so how we can assign these to the private variables? So this dot p1 equal to param1 So let me just change the name so it will be consistent everywhere. Okay, similarly you can assign this to all the variables we are having, p1, p2, p3. P2 is of type boolean, so and then it's 3. Okay, so this is how actually we are calling creating the constructor. And when I need to create the object of this class, I can just create the object, right? So here I need to pass the parameters while calling the constructor. So first one is the number, second one is the boolean, and third one is the string. Okay. Now you can create the object like this. You cannot create the object just by simply saying my class with empty constructor, because empty constructor doesn't even exist. You can also create a constructor, because there can be a constructor overloading. You can define a multiple constructor. Let me check that. What's the error? Multiple constructor implementations are not allowed. Okay, in this case, I will not be able to do that. Constructor overloading is not allowed. So, you need to pass the arguments for true and string. That's it. Okay, this is how the classes behaves in TypeScript.